His father killed himself, and so Republicans alleged that insanity ran in his family. Horatio Seymour, New York Democrats, he became governor in 1852. Undertook reforms in education and prisons, vetoed a state prohibition bill which might have cost him re-election. With the start of the Civil War, he maintained loyalty to the Union. Then in 1862, he was re-elected governor, put down the draft riots of 63. But many believed his fierce opposition to conscription had started the disturbance in the first place. And so once again he found himself in defeat. He was chairman of the Democratic Convention of 68. He tried in vain to insist that he was not a candidate on ballot 22. They nominated him unanimously, so he accepted the call, albeit reluctantly. He stood for amnesty for all former rebels, vowed to leave it to the southern states to decide whether or not to grant black suffrage, endorsed the use of greenbacks to redeem bonds, favored dismantling the Freedmen's Bureau and other vestiges of radical reconstruction. Republicans waged a bloody shirt campaign. They labeled the Democrats as the party of treason. Horatio Seymour never wanted to run, did all right in the popular vote, but the electoral vote was nothing about which to gloat.